Hello, and welcome to the next video in the TI Precision Lab series on external electrical overstress protection devices for ADCs. In this video, we will do a short review of the external devices that can be used to protect data converters from electrical overstress and the key specifications related to overstress protection. In particular, we will look at TVS diodes and Schottky diodes compared to PN diodes and Zener diodes. Looking ahead to the videos later on in this series, we will be covering how to run simulations with diodes for protecting data converters. As a reminder, in order to get the most accurate results with your simulations, you will want to download the SPICE model from the manufacturer. The next video will cover this subject in detail. This slide compares and contrasts the Schottky diode and the PN diode. For input protection, the Schottky diode is typically used because of its low forward voltage. The forward drop of a Schottky diode is typically 0.3 volts, whereas the forward drop for a PN junction diode is typically 0.7 volts. One benefit of a PN junction diode is that they tend to have lower reverse leakage current. However, be careful here as the PN diode leakage current has a stronger dependency on temperature compared to a Schottky diode. When selecting your diode, make sure to consider the whole temperature range and not only the room temperature leakage specification. Also keep in mind that any leakage current that passes through an impedance will generate an offset voltage. One of the most common devices used for protecting circuits from EOS damage is the transient voltage suppressor diode, or TVS diode. A TVS diode's behavior is similar to a Zener diode, but it is specifically designed for fast turn-on time and dissipating large transients. The plot on the right shows the IV curve for the TVS diode and points out the key locations on the curve. On the right side of the curve, the forward voltage VF is defined at forward current IF. On the left side of the curve, the reverse standoff voltage VR is shown with its associated reverse leakage current IR. The reverse standoff voltage is the maximum voltage that can be applied across the TVS diode while still maintaining a low leakage current. This is the off state for the TVS diode. The reverse breakdown voltage, VBR, is the point at which the TVS diode starts to break down and limit, or clamp, the voltage. Finally, the clamping voltage, VC, is the voltage across the TVS diode when the peak pulse current, or IPP, is flowing. If you look at the symbol for the TVS diode on the bottom left, you will see that it is a unidirectional device as it is a single diode with a forward and reverse direction. When in forward operation, the device has a very low forward drop of approximately 0.7 volts, and when in reverse operation, the diode has a drop approximately equal to the breakdown voltage. This type of TVS diode is useful if the normal operating voltage range is from 0 volts to standoff voltage. For example, a unidirectional TVS diode would be useful for protecting a 15-volt power supply. In this case, the standoff voltage would be set to 15 volts. The TVS diode would remain off from 0 volts to 15 volts, but would trigger on to protect fault voltages above 15 volts or below 0 volts. Here is another example of a TVS diode, but if you look at the symbol on the bottom left, you will see that it is a bidirectional diode as it contains two series diodes with their cathodes connected together. Since this TVS diode has two diodes in series, it can accommodate a negative to positive standoff voltage range, as you can see on the IV curve to the right. For example, a reverse standoff voltage of 15 volts indicates that the device will be turned off for signals from negative 15 volts to positive 15 volts with minimal leakage. Furthermore, a breakdown of 17 volts indicates that the device will turn on for voltages greater than positive 17 volts or less than negative 17 volts. This kind of TVS diode is useful for protecting against bidirectional input signals. For example, if you want to limit the input range of an ADC to plus minus 15 volts and protect against fault signals greater than plus minus 17 volts, you could use a bidirectional TVS diode with a standoff voltage of 15 volts and a breakdown voltage of less than 17 volts. On the previous slide, we introduced the TVS diode. A comparison of the IV curve of the TVS and Zener diode show that the two devices appear to have the same functionality, however there are some significant differences between the two devices. In general, TVS diodes are used for protection from ESD and EOS, whereas Zener diodes are used as voltage references. This slide highlights the differences between the two devices. First, notice that the two devices are both PN junctions. The Zener diode is normally operated in the reverse breakdown region to generate a voltage reference, whereas the TVS diode is normally only used in the reverse breakdown region for under or over voltage events. The TVS diode has a much larger junction area compared to the Zener diode, and as a result it can quickly absorb significant power strikes from EOS faults. Lastly, the TVS diode is designed to react much faster to transient faults compared to the Zener diode. This slide shows a brief overview of a TVS diode's power and current specifications. The key point to understand is that the peak pulse power rating is a transient rating for a finite pulse duration. There are two commonly spec transient pulse durations, 10 by 1000 microseconds and 8 by 20 microseconds. The pulse duration is broken into two sections, the rise time and the pulse width. For example, an 8 by 20 microsecond pulse has an 8 microsecond rise time and a 20 microsecond pulse width. As you might expect, the peak pulse power rating and the current rating relates to the width of the transient pulse. For example, the peak pulse power rating for the 1000 microsecond pulse width is lower than the 20 microsecond pulse. Most manufacturers will provide a curve that can be used to convert one peak pulse power for different pulse widths. In the bottom right, the slide shows how a 1000 microsecond pulse with a 200 watt rating can be converted to a 20 microsecond pulse with a 950 watt rating. The last rating that we'll cover in this video for TVS diodes is the steady-state power dissipation. Steady-state power dissipation is the maximum power that the device can continuously dissipate. This is important as some faults may happen for an extended period of time as opposed to a short 1 millisecond pulse. For example, many of the devices in this presentation are calculated using a 40 volt continuous fault. The curves shown here show how steady state power dissipation is rated versus temperature. Also, a similar derating curve is provided for the peak pulse current. That concludes this video. Thank you for watching. Please try the quiz to check your understanding of this video's content. Question 1. What are the main reasons to use a Schottky diode rather than a PN diode for input protection? The correct answer is E, both A and B. Schottky diodes have a forward drop of about 0.3 volts and are known for fast switching. Regarding answers C and D, the reverse breakdown is generally lower and the leakage is generally higher on a Schottky than a PN diode. Question 2. True/false. In some cases a PN type diode may be used in place of a Schottky diode because of its low leakage current. The correct answer is A, true. Although PN diodes have a higher forward breakdown, they are sometimes used in protection circuits when low leakage current is required. Question 3. What are the main reasons to use a TVS diode rather than a Zener diode for input protection? The correct answer is F, both C and D. TVS diodes are designed to dissipate large power spikes during a fault and switch quickly. Zener diodes, on the other hand, are designed to be a good reference. That is, they have better accuracy and lower noise. Question 4. True/false. The peak power rating will be lower than the continuous power rating on a TVS diode. The correct answer is B, false. The peak power rating is always higher than the continuous power rating. The peak power rating is the power that can be dissipated in the device for a pulse. For example, the peak power rating for a 1 millisecond pulse may be 200 watts, and a continuous rating may be 1 watt. Question 5. Which of the following is not true for a TVS diode with a peak pulse power rating of 200 watts for a 10 by 1000 microsecond pulse? The correct answer is C. The end of the pulse is defined where the current drops by 50%, not 10%. Question 6. If the normal linear input range of the ADC is plus minus 10 volts, which parameter on the TVS diode should be set to 10 volts or greater? The correct answer is B, standoff voltage. The TVS diode is meant to be operated with the reverse standoff voltage applied and the leakages defined for this voltage. The diode will break down at voltages higher than the standoff voltage.